I plead the blood of Holy Yahushua over this video and over the mind, body, and spirit of every child of Yah watching this video in Yahushua HaMashiach's holy name. Shag Shemayak, priests, and welcome back to Wakefulness Theology. My name is Messenger Paula, and today this is a special video for the Passover. So as you know, I've already explained that I received this message March 18th, 4:33 a.m. Holy Yahushua called me. I had a calling while I was sleeping, and he said that I am to write his name. And he told me to copy down the drawings because he's had Brother David, Priest David, Priest Poli, and myself work on this since the last playlist. And I've explained a little bit about the Hebrew letters at the end of the playlist and at the beginning of this playlist. Well, we've been working on that, and now on March 18th, he's come to me and he said, I have to write his name and I have to copy all those drawings that we've done and put them in order on one piece of paper with the tribes and the codes and their meanings, and I had to do this by Passover. So tomorrow is Passover, so I'm coming before you now humbly in obedience to what I was commanded to do. As I've explained before, this is a work in progress. This will be the next playlist. So I did my best here to write the meanings, but I believe that I will continue to understand more and more what the meanings are. This is just what I wrote here is what I have understood so far. So the full paper looks like this. Okay, this is the full paper. As you can see, it's a lot of information written on here. And in this video right here, I won't be able to go through all this information. This is going to be another playlist, as I've said before. But I just want to go through the important bits so that you understand. I was told to write his name, and this is what I've had confirmation. I had more than three confirmations, and I'm going to share that with you in this video, that this is how you write his name. Okay, right here. I'm not a scientist. I'm terrible at math. I'm not learned in religious studies, and I can't draw. Okay, I don't speak Hebrew. So, he's picked someone who has none of those abilities to do these things. I'm just sharing this information with you because often people, when I do these videos, and then you'll write and you'll say, well, I'm not good at math. I'm not good at the computer. I'm not good at it either, priests. I'm not. I can't draw. I can't add. I can't. None of it. None of it. You know, what you see me doing on these videos is through the grace of the Most High Father. It is the Holy Spirit. Okay, and I'm sure you can see in this picture that I really am telling the truth, that I cannot draw, okay? But I did the best that I could here, and I tried to make it bigger. So this is what it is. This is Holy Yahushua's name written. We have the Alpha, and we have the Omega, and we have the Yod. So when I drew the picture, I drew it like a modern I with the dot on top, but I should have drawn it like a yod, which would be the top of the iota. And we have the iota. So you can see when you put this together, it looks like a person. These are his legs. This is his body. This is his head, and you know, it kind of looks like hair too. This is his head, and this right here is the pineal gland or the brain. Okay, this is representing the brain. Now, the way that I understood this, I'm going to explain to you how I understood it, but I just want you to understand that we've been studying noon, and if you guys did the study last year when we finished the last playlist and we were told by the Holy Spirit to study Hebrew, if you did that work, ancient Hebrew, you will remember that noon is actually the symbol of the sperm, and this is in the otiot. Just like we learned in the last playlist, in a couple of playlists ago, that the alphabet, that is the Most High Father. That's why it is blasphemy when Google changed the name of their company to Alphabet, because we understood that the alphabet is representing the Most High Father, okay? It is the same for the ancient alphabet, the OTO, and you will understand that in a few minutes when I explain that. Here you will see that Nun, which we've already explained the connection with Joshua, the son of Nun, and Holy Yahushua through the Bible studies, how Joshua, the son of Nun, is symbolically representing Holy Yahushua. And we've proven that and shown that as well in the past. That's why I say, guys, if you are someone who don't know me, you don't know this channel, you can't just look at this one video and understand. It is 3 years of learning and studying that we've done through the Holy Spirit, taught by the Holy Spirit. We've put these messages together piece by piece over the years, and we've understood these pieces over time, and now I'm putting them together for you. So if you didn't get those pieces of information in the past, you're not going to understand what I'm talking about now, okay? So I just ask you to either A, go back, watch the videos and catch up on the information. They're playlists, they're in order, okay? Either do that or take this information to the Most High Father yourself and get your confirmation, but I would caution you to please not speak on things that you don't know. If you didn't get direct confirmation from the Father, then please don't speak on matters you don't know, because you don't want to blaspheme the Holy Spirit, and you do not want to quench the Holy Spirit, okay? You can't just get this information. You can't be a toddler in kindergarten and try to go to a university class. We're at a level here that if you haven't done the work, you're not going to get it. So please go back and do the work. Here, Nun, we've already studied the Hebrew ancient language, and we've understood that this is a sperm, okay? We also did the study about the male and the female and how a baby is formed. And we talked about Uranus, and we talked about how the sperm of a human man and a human woman in the egg goes through and it forms the nervous system. The sperm becomes your spine, and here we're talking about Jacob's ladder, yes, and the head of the sperm actually becomes your brain. It forms the brain. And this brother in Christ that you can see on the screen, we got that information from him. And then we went on to understand how this is not only in human man and woman, but this is also symbolic for the whole universe, okay? So that's what I want you to understand. This right here is this right here. This is noon right here, symbolically. This is this right here, which we've understood as ether. Now, again, you can't go and take human matters and translate it to godly, you know, the ways of Yah. They're not the same. They're not comparable, okay? So we're not talking about sperm. We're talking about the material, the fabric of the Most High Father making up the universe. And we're talking about it in human ways that we can imagine and understand. But that's not what it is. That's just how we're able to understand it as humans. Okay, so we're talking about the ether being inserted as far as the whole universe is concerned, and creating the body of Christ that we've already gone through. So that's what this picture is right here. This is the spinal column, and this would be the brain or the pineal gland, right? This is noon right here. So I'm going to explain in more detail why this is the way that we write Holy Yahushua's name, okay? I'm going to explain more in detail the I-A-O. But let me just show you quickly what I wrote here, and again, we'll go over it in the next playlist. So you can see that we have 10, 10, 11, 11, 12, 12, 13, 13, 14, 14, 15, 15, 16, 16, 17, 17, 18, 18, 19, 19, 20, 20, 21, 21, 22, 22, 23, 23. Above all of these, you can see that we have, I put the Hebrew letter that represents, so Yod is the 10th letter, Kaf is the 11th, Lamed, Mem, Nun, Shamak, etc. Pay, you see? So you can see the Hebrew letters over each of them. Then I put the name of the tribe. Now, I got the name of these tribes from scripture. Everything you see on this page is from scripture. It comes from Samuel 24, 13 through 16. And the way that I got this is because I was reading it at the same time. As I said, Holy Yahushua commanded me to read the Tanakh. Every sense, as I'm reading the Tanakh, the messages that I'm getting are going directly hand in hand with what I'm reading, okay? So when we were reading 2 Samuel, I was trying to understand the order of the tribes for this, okay? And as I was reading it, it said that Gad, but I knew right away that it was talking about the tribe Gad, and they were explaining how Gad had to come and bring the pestilence. And that's when I understood. Now, this happened way before China happened. This was, I don't remember the month, but it was at least a couple of months before the China thing happened last year. And it said that Gad would bring the pestilence. And so that's how I knew that pestilence would be coming. I didn't even have time to announce it or share it with you because it just happened like right after, like a month or two after I saw this, it happened. So I didn't even have time to understand the message, you know. But because of that, I knew that it was the last tribe, right? So I was able to, you know, because in the Bible you have many chapters that are talking about the tribes of Israel. So which verse is the correct order, you know? But now I knew that Gad was the last one because of the pestilence, because of 2 Samuel 24. So then at another time, I was talking about Ezekiel 48, our portions. And I don't know if you guys remember those videos, but again, if you've been following, if you've been watching these videos, the playlists in order, you know what I'm talking about. And so it's talking about our inheritance. And in that Bible verse, it includes within the 12 tribes, the Melchizedek priesthood and the Levite priests. Okay. And so I understood that these two priesthoods are included in the 12 tribes. Because they also get their own portion that is separate from the 12 tribes. And also there's Bible verses that's talking about how there's 12,000 that comes from each tribe. That makes up the 144,000. So I've already understood that, for example, I come from the tribe of Judah, right? I'm from the tribe of Judah. But as far as my portion, I'm inside the Melchizedek priests, right? So there are people from every tribe inside of the Melchizedek priesthood. I don't know if that's clear. And here again, I have to put on the screen the Bible verse that explains that we are priests. Okay, so don't let anyone else tell you something different. We are priests. And of course, the high priest, our leader, our savior is Holy Yahushua. But we are restored unto the Melchizedek priesthood when Holy Yahushua died on the cross. So that's how I got this order of the tribes. And so I'll just let you look at that for yourself. I don't want to read it right now. So another thing that was very interesting that I learned from doing this is that this again confirms the years. All right, priest? There's some things I've understood. So here, the two candlesticks. When it talks about the two candlesticks, there's seven branches on the candles, right? So there's 14 here, from 10:10 all the way down to 23:23 is 14 lines. If the menorah has seven branches, then 14 is two menorahs. And we know that the two menorahs represent the two candlesticks. So that's why I wrote that here. This is a candlestick, the first seven. So green unto purple is a candlestick. And then green unto purple again is the second candlesticks, the two candlesticks. Right here, I put 8 days of circumcision because we have seven and seven. So what that represents is you have seven, and then on the eighth day is when Holy Yahushua got his name. So you have seven units of measure. And then the eighth one is when you get your name. Okay. And that we can see in Luke 2:21. So that's why I wrote 8 days of circumcision, because Holy Yahushua got his name on the eighth day. You see that on Luke 21, you can read that. This right here, I put December 26, 2018, because that is when I got the message, "This week it begins." That is the message I got on December 26, 2018. And that's when I understood that that marked the beginning of sorrows. December 26, 2018 was the exact day that the beginning of sorrows began. Recently, I've understood that when it says "this week it begins," I've understood that week symbolizes a period of 7 years. Okay, I just realized this from Nainania when I was doing the video last week. So it was very simple. All I had to do was count from 2018. Now, you're not going to see 2018 on this right here. You see I put down the years. You're not going to see 2018 because it starts at 2021. What starts at 2021? Again, guys, I know it's a lot of information, and I will come back over other videos and explain this in the next playlist, but I'm just giving you a quick preview of what I put here. Now, going back down to Gad and the pestilence of 2020. So I knew in advance that Gad was meaning pestilence, and I knew that 2323 means the end. Because as I've told you in past videos, I had a dream that specifically told me 2323 means the end. Okay. So when I put all the tribes in order, it matched. Gad was with the end, and the end is pestilence. Okay. So that's how I knew that this right here represented 2020, because we're in pestilence. Okay. So that is the end of this process. I didn't count to see when this process began, but whatever year this process began, 2020 was the end. And that means that we're starting again at the top with 10:10 and Dan, and the year will be 2021. Does that make sense? I hope that's logical. Gad is the end, pestilence. This year is the end of whatever phase we just finished, and we're going to be beginning a new phase, which will be 2021. And that's why I started this countdown, this I don't even know what this to call this right now, at 2021. And we're going to go by 3.5 years, because I've already explained why. So you got 21 to 23, 22 to 25, 23 to 26, and I just counted all the way down. Okay. Again, as I've said many times, it doesn't mean that this starts here and stops here. You can see echoes of it starting before the year, and then it continues after the year. It's not a start and stop. It's just something for our human minds to kind of understand what's going on. It helps us understand better what's going on at that time period. Okay, but it's not a start and stop. It's a what should we be looking for? What's going on at that time? So we know that December 26, 2018, if this was the beginning of sorrows and the message I got said this week it begins, then we have to count from 2018, 2018, 2019, 2020, 2021, 2022, 2023, 2024. Okay, so that's why I put right here 2025 to 2028 sorrows. Okay, so right now we're in the beginning of sorrows, but actual sorrows, or I don't know if you want to call it tribulation, I just put sorrows, because if we're at the beginning of sorrows now, then the actual sorrows, full in sorrows, begins around this time. So we're talking 2024 to 2024 time. We're starting real sorrows. And again, that matches because what have I said all these years? We're going to be fully mature sons of Holy Yahushua by 2025. And we're going to be mature sons of Holy Yahushua by 2025 because we're going to go through all of this stuff that's going to happen. Now, we've already seen that in scripture and it lines up. Just go back and watch the old videos. So then I just put all these years, chronological order, 3 years apart. You can see it matches up. We've already talked about 2027. We said 2027 through 2031 is the watch years. And I want you to notice that the Melchizedek priest and the Levite priest, that is when they fall on this chart. Because the people that will be escaping in that escape will be the priests. The people who will be escaping in this escape, whenever it happens, this escape will be the priests. So again, we don't know the year or anything like that, but these years have been confirmed over and over and over. And here is another confirmation. It lines up. And again, what is the last year? The last year on the chart is 2037. Do you remember? I was just talking about that in the last video, and it was confirmed by scientifically.
But I don't think it'll be any longer than 2050. So it's within that. I've said 2037.
What was the other year that the brother said in the video? He said 2037. When you put the timelines to all the Bible verses together, all of them finish by 2037. All of them finish by 2037. 2037. Right here. Lines up. So you guys can do what you want to do with this information. I've already explained that over and over in the past. I just want to show you that the years once more line up. And here I put escaped because in theory, if I understand correctly, by this time, 2034, 2035, we will already have been gone. These priests right here will have escaped by 2034, 2035. It has already been done. And the window starts around 2026. We know also that we're expecting some kind of event where some saints are going to be going home soon. It'll be happening before the Prince of Persia arrives 2022. It could even be over Passover. It can be in April. It can be in May. It seems like it's going to happen very soon. But we know any time from now till before the Prince of Persia comes, this event is going to happen, the 116 event. Right now, it looks like it can be an earthquake. We're being warned about earthquakes. We're being warned about war. We're being warned about asteroids. We're being warned about all these things. We're being shown our transformation. We're being shown the escape. We're being shown all these things. And we don't know what it's going to be, right? But we know that something is coming soon. And that's why it is vitally urgent that we celebrate Passover this year. And that's why I'm doing this video right now. Because in the first original Passover, we are doing it again, just like they did in Egypt. This year is the Passover where you need to be at home with your family doing the celebration so that this judgment or this reward of the wicked will pass over you and your house. So please make sure you're doing the Passover this year. So here you can see the pictures that Brother David drew, and I'm going to show you his original pictures on the screen because my pictures don't do justice to what he did. But here's Yod, here's Kaf, here's Lamed, here is Mem, here is Nun, here is Samek, here is Ayen, here is Pei, and here is Tassad. Sorry, I like I said, I don't speak Hebrew, so if I'm mispronouncing something, please forgive me. This is Kaf, this is Resh, this is Shin, this is Tav, and this is Kof Kaf. Now, this right here, this is like 15 steps. Again, it's 14 levels, and the 15th step is when you arrive. This right here, this whole page, the name of Holy Yahushua, represents the steps of ascent that we're going through. And we're going to be going through the 15 steps of ascent from 2021 all the way until we escape. Okay, and maybe we'll escape early. He can call us early, or he can do what he wants to do. But we're going to be going through the steps of ascent. And this is what this represents. There is a connection between his name and these steps. I can't explain it right now, but it's something we'll look at in the next playlist. I assume it is that his name is the 15 levels of ascent, if that makes sense. But we write it this way, but all of this is also his name, because it is the alphabet. And we know that his name, like pi, is the physical manifestation of the representation, or the representation of his name manifested that we can see parts of, and the alphabet as well. Because numbers and letters, they're the same thing. That's why Hebrew, you have the alphanumeric. It's alphanumeric. It's the same. It's two different representations, but it's the same thing. And they are both concepts that you cannot touch. You cannot touch the number one. You cannot touch the letter A. They actually don't exist, but they do, right? These are representations of the Most High Father's name, okay? So that's why I'm saying all of this represents his name. Even though this is how we are going to write it. I just showed down here some watch periods that I've already explained in past videos. I just put them here. We want to Passover from the 5th to the 26th is important. Thanksgiving to New Year's 2020, high watch period. 2026 to 2032 is a high watch period for an escape. 2036 to 2042 is an escape watch as well, especially 2037. And then you have the second coming of Holy Yahushua that can happen anytime between 2052, 2062, and beyond, whenever. But I've already explained in the past these years, and I just think it's ironic how you have the 2, 2, 2, 32, 42, 62. You see that? And here you have 52 as well, but 26, 36, it's a pattern. I don't know what is the first escape, what is the second escape, what is the third escape. I don't know. So I wrote that here for the moment, but I don't know what to call it. I just know that this is a watch year, this is a watch year, and these are watch years. That's what I know for the moment. I should have just put watch time periods instead of putting first and second and third, because I don't know the order of that. And here I put some Bible verses where all of this information came from. So I'm not going to go through that right now, but if you are one of those people who are highly skeptical and you think I'm just pulling rabbits out of my hat, it's here in scripture, so you can look these up yourself, and I'll come back later and explain that. Here you have other symbols and codes for Holy Yahushua's name, because he told me to write his name, and I wasn't exactly sure, like, you know, so I just wrote everything. I wrote everything that I know about his name. Pi 44, we know, represents his name. 888 represents his name, and we know the hexagon represents his name, and all of these things we've already studied and learned in the past. Now, I want to explain that the Most High Father gave his name to Holy Yahushua, but not only did he give his name to Holy Yahushua, I want you to understand that Holy Yahushua is the name of the Father. I'll say it again. Holy Yahushua, his body, his head, his neck, his arms, his legs. You see right here? This is representing Holy Yahushua's head, his body, his legs, right? His actual self is the Most High Father's name. All right, so I'm going to show you this now, and I'm going to show you how the Most High Father gave Holy Yahushua his name. YHWH, which we understand as Yahuwah, and other people use different names, but we use Yahuwah. So he gave him his name. That's why it says YHWH is the IAO, is this, which is Holy Yahushua, because he gave him his name, or Holy Yahushua being is his name. Before I go on to explain about Holy Yahushua being the Most High Father's name, I want you to understand that why we have these two symbols like this. So you have the noon in the middle, which represents Holy Yahushua. And then on each side, you have the letter, which is representing the tribes. So these are people. These are people who become one with Holy Yahushua. And this is your new identity. Okay? Holy Yahushua is in the middle, and you become one with him. So I'm showing, you can look here, when the two shall become one, you have Mark 10:08, you have the Gospel of Thomas 22, and you have the Acts of Peter that explain this. And so again, I'll come back and talk about it in another playlist, but that's what these symbols are representing. It's representing each tribe, okay, coming together and becoming one with Holy Yahushua, creating the two becoming one, okay? That's what these symbols are representing. So again, like I said, another way of expressing his name. Now, there's the vow prophecy. Sister Polly received a message that said that the Most High Father's name is contained in the vowels. Now, I've already known that before you had this message, I already knew about the vow prophecy in the Nag Hammadi. I knew about it because I use codes in those ancient holy scrolls to decode the letter lines. And so that's a big part of it. So when Priest Poli told me about the vow prophecy, I already understood that it was in the vows, but we didn't know specifically how to form it or anything like that. Recently, as I was doing this work right here, which is an aspect of Holy Yahushua's name, Priest Judy was given the understanding of what it means that Holy Yahushua's name, or the Most High Father's name, they have the same name, is contained in the vowels. So now I want to show you that. So this is information that Priest Judy sent to me. I'm just putting it here. I'm not going to take the time to try to explain all this right now. I just want to show you where it came from. You have time to do your own research on it and take it to the Father and have Holy Spirit teach it to you. And again, I'll be coming back in another playlist to talk about this more in detail. But I just want you to see that it's explaining that the I-A-O, the iota, okay, the alpha and the omega, we can also understand this as sounds. Now, this is very important because when the 144 have a sound that only they know, we're talking about energy, and we've explained this in the past videos using scientifically how the Most High Father is an
energy
being, okay? So it's about being at that same frequency as him. When you're really under his wing of protection, you are with him like this because you are the same. This is a magnet, and they grab onto each other, right? We're not talking about the magnets that do like this where they repel each other. We're talking about these that grab onto each other. So this is the sound. And again, the sun, the moon, and the Saturn and all of this, we talked about how you see on the screen how the universal body of Christ is made up of the whole universe. And here is explaining the different sounds of the planetary spheres. And that equals I-A-O, the Alpha and the Omega. Yes, here's some more information that Priest Judy sent to me, and Priest Poli as well. The seven sacred vowels. So we understand that his name is contained within the vowels. I, H, E, A, O. I guess that would be U and Y. Or Ah, Law. And then you have, again, the planets that go along with that. And then this is the way you would write it. Again, I'll leave this. You can read it yourself. You can study this yourself. I'll come back and try to give more details in the next playlist. But if I try to do too much in this video, it'll be a 5-hour video. So I'm just giving you basic information about where the drawing came from, the way that I wrote his name. This is where it came from. The Alpha and the Omega and the Iota, which we also understand to be noon. So now I just want to give you some confirmation that this is correct. This is our Holy Yahushua told me, commanded me to write his name before Passover, and this is what I've done. Here it is, okay? And I'm going to give you confirmation that this is correct right now, because I asked Holy Yahushua to give me confirmation, of course. Now, this is just a random article that I just, you know, Googled to try to get some confirmation, and it says God has a name, and he's given it to Holy Yahushua. Now, I don't agree with everything in this article because they're using the name Yahweh and Jehovah. I don't believe that that's the correct translation of those names. They could be. That's not what I've understood in the past. And in past playlists and past videos, I went into detail explaining why and what. I went into detail about that. What I understand about his name, it's Yahuwah, okay? But that's neither here nor there. In the article, he's explaining how in the Bible verses, how we can see that Holy Father gave his name to Holy Yahushua. So this is an article that if you would like to read for more information, I'll leave it for you. Just some Bible verses that the article points out. Philippians 2, 9, 11. Isn't that funny? 9, 11 right here. Woohoo. Wherefore God also hath highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name. So we know that the name above every name is the Most High Father's name, isn't it? So he gave that to Holy Yahushua. That the name of Jesus every knee should bow, of things in heaven and things on earth and things under the earth, and that every tongue should confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, the glory of God the Father. Right here, Hebrews 1, 1 through 4, we have 4:11. Cool. God, who at sundry times and in diverse manners spake in time past unto the fathers by the prophets, hath in these last days spoken unto us by his Son, whom he hath appointed heir of all things, by whom also he made the worlds. So again, this picture you see here, it again confirms through scripture that all of the worlds, the whole universe, everything is Holy Yahushua. Confirmation for you that you can look up on your own. Some more confirmation I received. Now, I want you to understand the way that I received this confirmation. I do letter lines, and people who follow me, hopefully you know what I'm talking about. If you don't follow me, please go back and do your work. I can't spoon feed all of this to you. It's impossible. When I'm doing a letter line, I take a word. It's a human word. The human word has a spiritual meaning that is not the same as the human meaning. So the way I define the spiritual meaning of the word is I go to a code that the Holy Spirit taught me in the holy text. That includes the Bible, and it includes other texts like the Gospel of Thomas and other holy texts, okay? I get the definition, and then I use the Bible to confirm the definition of what I've understood, okay? So as I go through this process, very often the Bible verses that pop up to confirm the meanings of the words I'm defining at that time, very, very often it comments on the messages I'm receiving at the same time. So pretty much as I'm receiving messages, living my life, everything that I'm doing as far as reading, as far as writing or you know, for the ministry confirms the messages I'm receiving. It all works together at the same time. It's miraculous, okay? So at this time, I asked Holy Yahushua to confirm that I had written his name correctly. And Brother David sent me a message, and he said that he had received 46. So as I was writing, I was translating the letter line 46, and this is what came up in the letter line as I was writing it. Now this is the Gospel of Truth from Nag Hammadi. Okay, now this is translated by Robert M. Grant. You can have different translations. So this is where I understood, or should I say, this is where I had the confirmation. And the name of the Father is the Son. It is he who in the beginning gave a name to him who came forth from him. He is the same one, and he begat him for a son. Right here, noon. Right here, noon, because noon represents the ether that creates the spinal cord and the brain of the all of creation, which is his son, Holy Yahushua. He gave him his name, which belongs to him. He, the Father, who possesses everything which exists around him, he possesses the name, he has the Son. It is possible for them to see him. The name, however, is invisible, for it alone is the mystery of the visible about to come to ears completely filled with it through the Father's agency. So this right here is, again, another confirmation, because, again, letters and numbers don't actually exist. I can write number one on a piece of paper. I can write my name here. P-A-U-L-A. Okay. So that's my name. I wrote it here, right? That's my name. But that isn't me. It's not me. It's a representation of me, but it's not me, right? I can write A. But this A is a representation of a concept, a construct. It doesn't actually, it's not tangible. You will never be able to touch A, like I'm touching, this is a cup, I'm touching the cup. You will never be able to touch the letter A. Do you understand what I mean? So his name is invisible. It's invisible. We can't understand it. We can't say his name. It's just like above our understanding, but what we can see is evidence of it. We can see representations of it in the manifested world, which is through numbers and letters, the alphabet and pi, as we see in Exodus 3.14, where he says that it is his name, and 3.14 is pi. For it alone is the mystery of the invisible about to come to the ears completely filled with it through the Father's agency. Moreover, as for the Father, his name is not pronounced, but it is revealed through a son. Thus, then the name is great. Again, that's why Holy Yahushua said, write his name. We cannot pronounce pi. We don't even know all the digits of pi. You cannot pronounce the alphabet, like
supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
Like you, it's not going to work, right? It's not pronounced and it's invisible. But it is revealed through his son, Holy Yahushua, who is the name. So I can leave you to read the rest, and I might come back in the playlist and talk more about it, but you get the idea. Confirmation. And again, this is from the Gospel of Truth. Okay, you can look it up yourself. I'll put it in the comment section. Another confirmation, I told you, believe it or not, I got it from Boss Baby. Now, I told you, I've explained to you guys that I prayed that Holy Father would explain to me these really complicated, difficult messages. Just explain it to me like I'm a 7-year-old child. Just explain it to me like I'm a kid, you know? And he has. He's been using cartoons and movies and TV shows to explain these very complicated matters to me. So I was watching Boss Baby. I usually watch cartoons. I can't take the violence and the cussing. I'm really PG-13. I can't do more than that. Unless Holy Spirit tells me to watch a movie specifically for a message or something. Like, I'm strictly PG-13. So I was going to watch Boss Baby the other day. And then I noticed this. Do you see this head here? And you see this tie here? And you see the legs right here? So priest, I want you to understand that this right here is this right here. This right here is this right here. You have this blue that goes around the head, which is here, right here. You can kind of see it with the ears where it goes out. You see the head right here, okay? The head, this is the head. You even have like this little curl, which could represent, you know, right here. Then you have this tie, which is representing this right here, and you have the legs, which is the A. So as soon as I saw that, I was like, oh, this is a mockery. This is a mockery. They're mocking us as usual, because we can't even recognize the name of our Savior. We're blind. We're spiritually blind and we're spiritually deaf. We can't even see the name of our Savior right here. They're mocking us. And that's how I knew. I was like, this is confirmation. So I was like, well, let me watch this TV show. Let me watch this movie. So I was watching the movie, and then I saw this, and I was like, shut up. Look at this, guys. The truth is, I'm no ordinary baby. I'm on a mission from above. Are you the baby Jesus? Yes, I'm the baby Jesus. Is that not confirmation for you? I don't know what is. They put his name on the title, and then they say right here, I know it was a joke in the TV show, but they're mocking us, okay? Confirmation that that is the correct way to write his name. So the other thing about Baby Boss, I got the confirmation, another confirmation from this movie, where Priest Judy sent me on Facebook, she sent me what the world needs now is love, sweet love. She just sent it to me for no reason. She didn't say anything. She just sent me the video of Dionne Warwick's song, What the World Needs Now is Love, Sweet Love. So I was like, okay, whatever. And then I was watching this movie with Baby Boss, and guess what the end song is? Sweet love. Yes, What the World Needs Now is Love, Sweet Love. At the end of the movie, when that song came on, I just about lost it. I was like, okay. So the main message, besides Holy Yahushua wanted me to write his name, the other message that you have to understand, priest, is that we're called right now to love the world, not the flesh. I'm not saying the fleshly world. I'm saying human people. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Let's look at the lyrics. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Not just for some, but for everyone. And so I'll let you read the whole thing for yourself. But this is the message that Holy Yahushua wanted me to tell you. The Holy Spirit wanted me to tell you this message, that we have to love our enemies. And I mean, really love them. You need to pray for your enemies just like you pray for your family and your friends. You have to pray that your enemies are convicted in their spirit, and that they repent, and that they find the Holy Yahushua so that they'll be saved. You pray for the redemption and the salvation and the well-being of your enemies, priests. You pray for murderers, even pedophiles, narcissists, evil men. You pray for everybody, and you love everybody. You don't have to love the evilness that they do, but they are human, and Holy Yahushua died for everybody. And so you must pray and love, not, what does it say right here, not just for some, but for everyone. He died on the cross for everyone. Every saint was a sinner, and every sinner, tomorrow they could be a saint. You have to love everyone. We don't have to love things that are not human. So entities that are not human, we don't have to deal with that. But that we rebuke evil entities and evil things. We rebuke that in Yahushua Mashiach's holy name. But the human beings, we have to love them no matter what. So what you need to be doing right now at this time of upheaval that's going to be happening, we don't know what the 116 event is going to be, whatever it's going to be, what you need to be doing as a priest is loving people, everybody, especially your enemies, especially those who are lost. So if you love Trump and this person don't love Trump, you gotta love them anyway. If this person believes in the rapture and that person don't believe in the rapture, you gotta love them anyway. If this person done killed people and he's in jail and he's a liar and a manipulator, you gotta love them anyway. Take the time to figure out how you're going to give love to the world, because that's what we need right now. We don't need another mountain, another metal. We don't need another moonbeam. We don't need more toilet paper in our house. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. Okay, I don't know if I shared that message with you well enough, but that is what's going to separate the chaff from the wheat. That's what's going to separate you from someone in the tribe of Judah to being someone in the Melchizedek priest. Can you love your enemies? Can you love everyone? No matter what they've done, as long as they're human beings, you have to love them. I don't care about their sexuality. I don't care about their color. I don't care about their beliefs. I don't care what they've done in their life. Love them. That's what you need to pray on for this Passover. That was the message. So here we are, the letter line 46 that brother, that priest David gave me, and it confirmed the name that I had understood to write for Holy Yahushua. You can go on the website, and all you have to do is just write right here, 46, and it'll come up. Or you write right here, Passover, and the information will come up. So here, I don't really think we have the time for me to read this aloud, but just pause the video. You can read it for yourself. You can go to the website and read it for yourself. But you'll see that it confirms right here what I read to you earlier of from the Gospel of Truth is written right here, because it was part of the definition of the letter line 46. Okay, and you can see right here I wrote the Most High Father's name is Holy Yahushua. And I added the what Holy Yahushua told me to write his name, because 46 is a direct confirmation of that right here for you to see. So Holy Yahushua answered me when I was asking for confirmation. He explained to me why it was important for us to know his name before the Passover. And this is it. We can see it in Psalms 91. And if you go all the way down to 91, 13, and 14, of course, 14 is very important. We know that what that represents, the called and the chosen. The reason that I found this is that because Priest Brittany had a confirmation about trampling upon the dragon. She had a snake that she crushed with her foot in real life, and then she had a dream about crushing the head of a snake. And I also had a dream about the head wound, which I'll explain in another video. So this came to my mind because it says right here, thou shalt tread upon the lion and the adder, the young lion and the dragon shalt thou trample underfoot or feet. And then the very next verse is, because he hath set his love upon me, therefore I will deliver him. I will set him on high because he hath known my name. And again, I had a dream about being high. I was high up before I had to go down. They wanted me to take the vaccine. If you guys remember the dream I had about lock and key, that dream I had about the vaccine. Well, I was up high, and I had to go down low to refuse this vaccine. So this is very important that we know his name, because the people who know his name are the ones that will be delivered. And that's why he asked me to write his name before Passover, because this is really the time that's going to set apart those who are going to be a part of that priesthood that will be delivered, and those who will not, those who know his name. And his name is Holy Yahushua. Can I get a hallelujah? Can I get a whoop whoop? So to finish, Passover is super important this year. In order to be in covenant with the Father and really showing that you understood him. He has been talking to you. He has been growing you and teaching you and making you and all of that. So for you to say back to him, Father, I've completely understood these things. And yes, 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 right? We're going to be in covenant with him and be at home with our families or with our brother in Christ. And we're going to partake of Passover as a symbolic way of saying to Holy Father that we are with him. Okay, we're together in communion. We're together in covenant with the Most High Father. This is a symbol of that, the Passover, so that we won't partake in the reward of the wicked. We will not partake in the reward of the wicked. We need to honor Passover this year. So again, just go to the website, put Passover, and I put to the best of my ability information here for you about how to honor Passover. Here's a video. here's a website, here's how to make the matzah, and here's some blessings, here's some prayers. Priest Colleen, she shared with us some of her information here. You just can download that, and there you go. So please, if you need more information about Passover, it's right here. Also, you just come to the website and you put spiritual practice, and that pops up here. I've done videos about this in the past. And here I put what you need to be doing, because people are asking me, because we've received the warning that you have to be doing your duties as a priest before the 116 event. We had to acclaim our priesthood and our position in Christ last year. Okay, so some of us did it, but after you claimed your position, you haven't been doing the job. Holy Yahushua brought it to my mind how it works. You have to be in action. So for example, Holy Yahushua, he is the Messiah. He is our Savior. Why is he our Savior? Is he our Savior because we just say he's our Savior? Like if we give him the title Savior, does that make him the Savior? No, it's not because we give him the title Savior that he's the Savior. It's because he did the work. He died on the cross for our sins, and therefore he is the Savior. So it is not the title that makes him who he is. It's the action of doing that made him who he is. Do you see what I'm saying? So you calling yourself priest, you can call yourself rabbit. It doesn't make you a rabbit. If you have claimed yourself as a priest, in order to actually be a priest, you have to do your duty, okay? So if you don't know what your duty is, it's most likely probably because you are not doing any kind of spiritual practice. You need to be doing things to help yourself to be spiritually maturing. When I started honoring the Sabbath, that is when I went up a step. When I started fasting more regularly, that's when I went up a step. When I did that 40-day fast. When I started reading the Bible and reading to the Tanakh, you go up, you go up, you go up, you go up. These are levels. Like we've talked about, as a baby, you can't go from being a baby in the womb to being a 40-year-old man. You have to go through that process. So you who have claimed the title priest and you're just sitting back and going, I don't know what to do. I don't know what to do. That's not true. There's a whole playlist that we've done, How to Get on the Ark, that tells you specifically what to do step by step. And if you didn't see that, if you don't have time to see that, you can come here. The spiritual practice, these are some of the things. You don't have to do exactly what I'm saying here. You can do whatever you want to do, but you need to be doing something. It's like a muscle. It's like a spiritual muscle. You know what I mean? You can't go from nothing to not knowing anything about Holy Yahushua to being a priest if you don't exercise. So you have to grow. And how do you do that? It's a daily practice. And so here are some things you can do. I put all the information here for you, all right? But you need to be doing it before the event happens. After the event happens, it's another way. It's another people, it's another job, it's another situation, it's something else, okay? If you wanna be on this boat that we've been on this whole time, you need to be in action before that event happens, okay? And you definitely need to be honoring Passover this year on Wednesday. Holy Father, I pray that I've been obedient and I've done what you've asked me to do. I pray that I've done it justice and that I've clearly explained to the brethren and that they understand the message. And I pray that you are happy with my drawing, how I've written your name. And I thank you for giving me the information. It was miraculous the way that you taught me and showed me this information, Father. And I gave you all the glory and the praise and the honor. And I thank you for it, Father. And I just pray that your will be done in our lives and on earth as it is in heaven. Thank you for your holy feast days, your Passover. And I look forward to celebrating it with you priests. Jonathan Kahn is doing kind of a live cast. So I hope I will try to tune in and to do that with Jonathan Kahn. I'm putting the information on the screen. So if you like, you can also watch that. Also, we're going to meet in Wakefulness Theology prayer group. So if you would like to meet and pray with us on the Passover, you have to go to Facebook and join the Facebook group. So if you don't want to join us on Facebook, you just come to the website, you click on groups, you join us here in the prayer group. So you click on that. Of course, you have to be, when you register for the website, you get approved. And then when you join the group, you have to get approved. These are just safety measures we use so that we don't get bothered, because we want to make sure that there aren't any bots. And we also want to protect ourselves from enemies. But you can come here, and every week we will put the link to the Zoom prayer group so that you can join us. So this is where we meet. If you don't want to join us on Facebook, where we also put the link, the Zoom link, every week. So please, you join us on the Facebook group, and then from there we have a link for Zoom where we meet and we pray together on audiovisual, the audiovisual Zoom platform. And we do that every Friday at 5 for Sabbath, and this week we're going to do it for Passover. It's only a half an hour, so please join us if you feel called to do that. I'm going to end with "What the World Needs Now Is Love, Sweet Love," and just as the song goes off, just listen to the words and pray on it. Really pray on it. You have to have an open heart. You have to be able to love everybody, even your enemies. If you consider yourself a priest, this is what you are called to do. So if you're not there, you have to get there. And please be there before the 116 event, okay? I love you guys very much in Christ. All glory to the Most High Father. I am this perfect day, and within me, the light which does not fail dwells. Holy is Yahushua. Shalom.
What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another mountain. There are mountains and hillsides enough to climb. There are oceans and rivers enough to cross, enough to last till the end of time. What the world needs now is love, sweet love. It's the only thing that there's just too little of. What the world needs now is love, love. No, not just for some, but for everyone. Lord, we don't need another meadow. There are cornfields and wheat fields enough to grow. There are sunbeams and moonbeams enough to shine. Oh, listen, Lord, if you want to know. Everyone.